Welcome to Maverick Fish Hunter, hosted by Troy Isaac. Featured gear used on this episode, Berkeley. American Angler. Ram Mounts. Glacier Glow. Flying Fisherman. Buff. Royal Distributing. Mustad. Fluger. Ram 1500. Fins. Yamaha Wave Runner. Rapala. Abu Garcia. Staples. Vexlar. Navionics, Suffix, and Parts Unlimited. Maverick Fish Hunter, your home for jet ski fishing. Today we're going to be hunting rainbow trout on the St. Mary's River. This is a perfect example of what we're after. Pink stripe down the side, green back, silver belly, white mouth with a flat tail. This is Bellevue Marina. There are 177 slips here, fuel and transient docking. We're heading out onto the shipping channel. These freighters are called Lakers. Here on the Great Lakes. We'll be using a Yamaha Wave Runner FXHO 2007. Let's get underwater here with the fish. Check out a beautiful rainbow trout. We're in 5 to 7 feet of water, traveling approximately 2 to 4 miles an hour down current. Notice the bottom. Perfect rocky bottom for rainbow trout. We're using a Fluger reel and an Abu Garcia rod. This fish is perfectly hooked on a Rapala. We're using a variety of crankbaits today, blues and greens, yellow, red, oranges work as well in shallow water. Adult freshwater rainbow trout average between 1 and 5 pounds, while lake dwelling trout may reach up to 20 pounds. Many anglers consider rainbow trout the hardest fighting fish species, as this fish is known for leaping when hooked, putting up a powerful struggle. It is considered one of the top 5 sport fish in North America. Here you can see the Maverick Deluxe bag we use for storing fish on the water. Personally, I wrap them in bags to keep the mess down inside the catch bag. It's lined with a waterproof seal. This is a rainbow on the bottom, Atlantic salmon on the top. Notice the Atlantic is black checkered marsh across the top, and the rainbow has a shorter, stouter face. St. Mary's River drains Lake Superior starting at the end of Whitefish Bay, flowing 74 miles or 119 kilometers southeast to Lake Huron with a fall of 23 feet. 21 of those feet are right here at the locks and the rapids. Another beautiful rainbow. Having some good luck today. Great fighting fish. They just never give up. Magnificent animals full of strength.
We
We'll be right back to Maverick Fish Hunter, your home, jet ski fishing. The Hero Class Patrol Vessels are a series of 9 vessels constructed by Halifax Shipyard for the Canadian Coast Guard. Each vessel is approximately 42 meters in length with a top speed of 25 knots. North America Coho Salmon is a fantastic game fish in both fresh and salt water, especially with light fishing tackle. Is one of the most popular sport fish in the Pacific Northwest of the United States and Canada. Its popularity is due to the reckless abandon in which it displays chasing bait and lures. We're in front of the Edison Power Plant at this time, located at the eastern end of St. Mary's Power Canal, which runs between Lake Superior and Lake Huron through the city of Sault Ste. Marie. It is one of the longest hydroelectric power plants in the world at 1,340 feet. You can see how these coho fight. And they travel in schools. And they are aggressive. When you get into a school, we picked up 5 within an hour. Very active. You can see all of this action is literally right at your feet. It's a nice calm day, 25 degrees Celsius. Using an older Abu Garcia rod. I don't believe they make this line anymore, but it sure does work well. It's caught plenty of fish. Perfect size. Light tackle. Foggy morning here in Sault Ste. Marie, down at the marina, heading out into the canal to enjoy another day of fishing. This fog is created by warm summer winds blowing up from the south, hitting this cold water coming out of Lake Superior, creating this fog vapor, which can become very thick on the St. Mary's River. I'd like to point out the back and forth motion of the fishing rods mounted to the steering wheel with the ram rod holders. I've nicknamed it Jig Trolling, and it works so very well. This is a local tour boat. Book a tour. Another day of fantastic coho fishing. They love to jump. That's what makes it so exciting to fish. Back at the marina, we refuel for another afternoon on the water. Slow motion rainbow jumping. That turned out to be a very nice rainbow trout. And true to their nature and reputation, again, one of the best things about jet ski fishing is the action is right at your feet. Just another beautiful example of rainbow trout in the Great Lakes. Beautiful addition. Here you can see the shallows that a jet ski can get into. If you brought a boat in here, just about any boat, you'd be knocking props off the rocks and damaging your boat. With a jet ski, you can slip in and out of these areas. Not so much for fishing in these shallows, but sometimes you have to get through the shallows to get to the spot. And again, we're into another rainbow. This is a great shot of the setup on the jet ski, sonar, fish finder, bait board, camera posts, rod holders, handlebar bags. Handlebar bag acts as a small tabletop for pliers, for removing hooks, changing lures. Very nice addition. Here we are at the St. Mary's Canal on the Canadian side. The lock was built in 1798 by the Northwest Trading Company. The lock was destroyed in 1814 and attacked by the American forces during the War of 1812. The construction of the canal and reconstruction of the lock was completed in 1895. At that time, it was the largest lock and the first electrically operated lock in the world. The canal is about 1.6 kilometers or 1 mile long. The Bombardier 415 Super Scooper is a Canadian amphibious aircraft purpose-built as a water bomber. It's an aircraft designed and built specifically for aerial firefighting. 415 can scoop up 1,620 U.S. gallons of water. It didn't take long, back into the action. Another beautiful rainbow for the day. This is the Sault Ste. Marie Rapids. We're going up the base of it. You can see how shallow it gets. The current is very strong here. Basically, only a jet ski could get up here to fish. And it's produced some results. Another beautiful rainbow for the day. Beautiful, beautiful fish. Quite privileged to be able to fish this area. Beautiful yellow fins, mature rainbow. This FX high output wave runner is powered by a 1052cc 4-cylinder 4-stroke MR1 engine. Say hello to the tourists. Goodbye, tourists. This Rapala 3-inch crankbait perfectly hooked at the corner of this rainbow trout's mouth. Notice the gold, almost bronze color of these rainbows. Very nice, great variations in this area. The Maverick bags used on this trip have performed flawlessly. Come on back now. This plane is coming out of the Canadian Bush Plane Heritage Center, located on the north bank of St. Mary's River, Sault Ste. Marie. It is dedicated to preserving the history of bush flying and forest protection in Canada. Bush flying transformed the north. It became possible by the 1930s to charter an aircraft and fly just about anywhere. We're doing about 55 miles an hour and the bush plane has lifted off. Wild caught and hatchery reared forms of rainbow trout have been transplanted and introduced for food or sport in at least 45 countries and every continent except Antarctica. Other introductions into waters previously devoid of any fish species or with severely depleted stock of native fish have made world-class fishing, such as here in the Great Lakes, where we are, and Wyoming's Firehole River. Rainbow trout, including steelhead forms, generally spawn in early to late spring when water temperatures reach at least 42 to 66 degrees Fahrenheit, 6 to 7 degrees Celsius. The maximum recorded life span of a rainbow trout is 11 years. We're fishing in 7 to 8 feet of water. It's late spring, third week of June. The run of steelhead and rainbow is just about over for the year. We're fishing right beside the Sioux Locks. The locks pass over an average of 10,000 ships per year, despite being closed during the winter months from January through March, when ice shuts down the shipping on the Great Lakes. The net I use is a telescopic net, rubberized netting material, very good for getting out your hook once you land your fish, when inevitably the hook is going to get into the netting material. Here you can see we're using the Maverick Deluxe catch bag. This is our local U.S. conservation officer boat coming to have a look. Here's a shot of the stunning new Pearl Mist, offering the ultimate cruise experience with over 100 oversized luxurious staterooms, each with a private balcony. Fish on! It's getting late in the day. We're in evening light, hitting orange, red, pink grapples, 3-inch crankbaits. Another beautiful fish. We catch and release most of the fish that we bring into the boat. Another shot of the Edison power plant. This is a good indication of how you can idle your jet ski. The current coming out of the exhaust vents that you can see here in these arches allows me to sit there and maneuver from spot to spot. The acceleration on a jet ski, a lot of fun. We're into some white water, no problem. This is all second nature, no problem for a jet ski, lots of power. I regularly go up a little further than this even. You can see how stable all the gear is, even under harsh conditions, rod holders, GPS fish finder, camera post. Another beautiful northern Ontario sunset. Thanks for joining us on this episode of Maverick Fish Hunter. Special thanks to our contributing gear suppliers. Come back and join us for our next episode on Lake Superior, Lake Trout Hunting.